Hide me in your church that's really applaud the Lord and
Church of Our Lady of Lourdes Whitehead, and to all those joining us online from home. You are indeed all very welcome as we come together, gathered as one body in Christ, to celebrate our second parish Lenten service. Today we will be contemplating on the Passion of Christ while following the stations of the cross. I would now like to invite Mary Muir and Mary Glenn to lead us in our reflections this evening on Christ's love which knows no half measures.
Jesus, my Saviour, I want to walk with you on the way of your cross. For love of you, I am heartily sorry for my sins. I beg of you the grace to make this way of the cross in the spirit of true penance, in union with that spirit with which you yourself went up to Mount Calvary. I offer this devotion in thanksgiving for your love and in satisfaction for my sins and the sins of my brothers and sisters. The first station, Jesus is condemned to death. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you,
because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Jesus was bound and handed over to Pilate. What am I to do with this man? Pilate asked. Crucify him, they all cried. He said, why, what crime has he committed? But they shouted the louder, crucify him. Pilate washed his hands and declared, I am innocent of the blood of this just man. Responsibility is yours. Rather than face the truth, Pilate condemned the God-man to death.
Lord Jesus, let me not run from my own or others' problems, nor in desperation accept an unjust solution that hurts someone else.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The second station, Jesus accepts his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you,
because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Jesus was already exhausted from his agony in the garden, his sleepless night of trial, the scourging and crowning of thorns. But when handed the cross, he took it. He emptied himself, becoming like us in all things but sin. Now he shouldered the burden of our sins.
Out of love for you, Jesus. I will empty myself of selfishness and make a new attempt to accept my crosses. Forgive my complaining and my resentment of the sacrifices I must make to love and serve others.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The third station, Jesus falls the first time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by the holy cross we have redeemed the world.
The burden was too heavy. The cross forced Jesus down. He stumbled and fell, but he struggled to his feet and tried once more. He did not let the difficulties or pain shake his determination. He forced himself to stand up, painfully lifted the cross to his shoulder, and tried again.
Jesus, I follow. I fail. I will accept my weaknesses and try again, believing in the strength you give me.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The fourth station, Jesus meets his sorrowful mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Jesus and Mary meet and suffer with one another. There wasn't anything Mary could do to save her son. Like a parent beside the hospital bed of a sick child, Mary had to stand by helplessly and watch her son's agony. Even when we cannot free others from their burdens, we can support and console them by our prayer.
Lord Jesus, let me be understanding to the sick, the depressed, the confused, even when I do not understand their sickness and pain.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The fifth station, Simon helps Jesus carry his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by the holy cross you have redeemed the world.
As they led Jesus away, they laid hold on Simon of Cyrene, who was coming in from the field. They put a cross beam on Simon's shoulder for him to carry along behind Jesus.
Simon helped reluctantly. Jesus, let me help cheerfully. What we do for our neighbours, we do for you. Your apostles deserted you in time of need. A stranger had to be forced to help you. I make up my mind now not to disappear when a friend needs me.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The sixth station, Veronica presents her veil to Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Veronica volunteered to help Jesus. She saw his sweaty, bloody face and was moved by the pain she saw there. She did not hesitate to get her veil bloody and stained.
Jesus, help me see your image in all the people I meet, especially those suffering from rejection, loneliness, alcohol, or drugs. By my own kindness and by supporting others who help the troubled, I want to relieve your pain.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The seventh station, Jesus falls the second time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross we have redeemed the world.
Even with Simon's help, Jesus falls again. In many things we fail, as individuals, as families, as a parish, as a nation. It takes repeated effort to control our tempers, or to learn the art of prayer, or to rise to the challenge of real self-giving.
Jesus, help me to keep on trying. When I accept your healing in the sacrament of penance. Never let your pilgrim people grow weary of trying to follow in your footsteps.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The 8th station, Jesus speaks to the weeping woman. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. A great crowd of people followed him, including women who beat their breasts and lamented over him. Jesus turned to them and said, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me. Weep for yourselves and for your children."
Jesus, merely to feel sorry for the poor or starving is not enough. We need your help to change our world, so that all people can live decently and have enough to eat. We weep for our own sins of excess and selfishness, and resolve to change our lives.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The 9th station, Jesus falls the 3rd time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Totally exhausted, Jesus falls to the ground for the 3rd time. What a terrible burden our sins must be. It took complete trust in his Father and great power of will for Jesus to get up once more.
Lord Jesus, following you sometimes calls for all the energy we have. But if we trust in you, we will be made strong in spite of our weaknesses. St. Paul begged 3 times that the thorn in his flesh be taken away. Jesus, you answered as you answer us. My grace is enough for you.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The 10th station, Jesus is stripped of his garments. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by the holy cross you have redeemed the world.
The soldiers roughly tear off Jesus' clothing, though it is matted in his wounds. His persecutors have taken advantage of his weakness. They have refused to treat him as a human being.
Lord Jesus, never let us take advantage of others or try to use them for our own selfish purposes. Do not let us rob the poor and helpless of their dignity. As your people, your church, let us always stand up for the oppressed. We ourselves pledge to treat everyone as a child of God.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The 11th station, Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
The pain bolts through the body of Jesus as nails are driven into his hands and feet. His thanks for announcing the good news of the kingdom of God was crucifixion as a criminal. It was a convenient way to get rid of him and his goodness.
If we want Jesus, we can shut you out of our lives. We can ignore your call to love. As an individual or as a community, we can pretend not to hear your invitation to take up our cross and follow you in the way of generous self-giving.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The 12th station, Jesus dies on the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Writhing in agony on the cross, Jesus pleaded, "Father, forgive them. They know not what they are doing." Turning to the thief, he said, "This day you shall be with me in paradise." In pain, Jesus cried out, "My God, why have you forsaken me?" Then he said,
said, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." And he gave himself up to death.
Nothing was too much for Jesus to do for us. Love knows no half measures. Lord Jesus, help us to trust our loving Father and to be good to others despite what is done to us.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The 13th station, Jesus is taken down from the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you,
because we have been crucified in the world.
When the body of Jesus is lowered from the cross, it is laid in Mary's arms. How immense was her sorrow. As a mother, she remembers holding him as a child and fleeing from Herod to protect him. She recalls the prophecy, "And your own soul a sword shall pierce." Her mother's heart cannot understand the reason, but Mary still has hope. She trusts in the promise made to her by the angel that her son would save his people, would save me and you.
Sorrowful mother, help us to listen to the words of your son. Be with us at the hour of our death.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
The 14th station, Jesus is laid in the tomb. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
As we have on the cross, we have redeemed the world.
They took the lifeless body of Jesus and wrapped it in linen cloths with spices. This lifeless body would soon rise victorious over sin and evil.
Jesus, in baptism, we went down into death with you and rose with you to a new life of grace. May this new life in us grow each day so that we may conquer our selfishness. Welcome and forgive all human beings and work to make the world a better place for all. May we so live in your resurrection that your kingdom may be visible to all the world. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Come, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus crucified,
have mercy on us.
like to thank you all for joining us here this evening, both in the church and online. We hope you will be able to join us again next week, where we will pray the Stations of the Cross in Carrickfergus, which will be led by our youth in the parish. We will now have our final hymn.
To you.